All right, guys, welcome to Coach's Corner, really the best part of the stream, and we've been neglecting a little bit due to my real life, but welcome. So Coach's Corner, what it is, for those of you joining us now, it's really a segment every weekend to better yourselves as a player. It's geared towards those that are, you know, becoming normal, heroic, mythic raiders, and many of you guys have gone from this LFR 0 to mythic raiders. You've put in the work, you know, you've been shown how to do those things, how to run guilds, how to be good officers, how to be good leaders, how to use weak auras, how to read logs. We've done all of it. We're going to be running through those things again in this segment. This one is titled Becoming a Better Raider. This one is Getting Gear and Getting Experience. So when you're going back to the game, or if you're that aspiring mythic raider, you are that, you know, heroic geared player. You've maybe done, you know, one mythic, maybe you've probably done a bunch of heroics, but you really want to get into the heroic scene. Well, let's see, your armory is something like this one. This is Spartana. This is my sort of, you know, my little other holy paladin mold, because I love holy paladins. Let's take a look at his gear really quick. So his gear is what, 720, so he's got some heroic pieces, he's got some more heroic pieces. Look, this guy's slacking, he hasn't been upgrading any of it. He's got a heroic piece here, he's got mythic boots that I bought for him, because, you know, I've got some decent gold, mostly heroic pieces, but he is 728, which is pretty damn good, and that's more than enough for mythic rating. Realistically, in terms of actual item levels, 710 is what heroic Archimonde is geared towards. So if you're in 710, right, when we were initially doing progression back in normal and heroics, 710 was the ballpark. 710 was what the encounter was geared towards. Anything higher, and I know all the moose runs now, all the carry raids want 720, 730, 740 for heroic, which is just insane. But it's geared towards 710, you know, a fairly decent group. It's really easy now to get geared up, partly through those valor upgrades, right? These 2 out of 2 valor upgrades, 0 out of 2 here, again, that slacker. And you can see I got a couple of mythic pieces because I did join a guild for a mythic run. So there's lots of different ways to get geared. And here's a great link for you guys. This one is on Wowhead. And this is gearing up for the... There it is in chat. Gearing up for the 6.23 Immortan Mount and Heroic Archimonde. Different ways to get geared up, from Supreme Lord Kazak, which gives you 705 to 721 gear every week. Baleful gear. So let's say you're coming back to the game. You've got the very basics. Well, Baleful Tanan stuff, or killing the rares in Tanan, will give you some pretty decent loot, including these empowered Apexis fragments. Once you get more Apexis, and you can get, you know, 700 item level stuff. At that level, you're totally ready for heroics. In addition, you could also do PvP. So PvP is fantastic. I know PvP people scoff at that. Gone are the days of resilience taking away from critical strike and haste and mastery and all that other stuff and multi-strike, which thank God they're getting rid of. PvP is totally viable. If you go to Ashran, I know how much people love going to Ashran right now. I'm in Legion now, but if you go to Ashran, really easy to get geared there. And that PvP gear is completely viable in a raid setting. There is nothing wrong with it. In some cases, those blue PvP pieces are better than normal raid pieces. So completely viable. The trinkets are really the only thing. They're not as effective in PvE because a lot of them are, versatility or, you know, PvP trinket, those kinds of things. So lots of different ways to get geared. Well, you know, let's say you're in a Spartana situation here, right? This paladin here is Spartana in Zeros to Heroes, which is our community guild, wants to do some kind of mythic raiding. He's been watching Sparty's stream and he's aspiring to be a holy paladin like this guy, because he sees how much, you know, Sparty likes, for me, likes to heal, and how much fun I have on beta or in World of Draenor healing, and how much I love and how much passion I have for it. Well, this guy wants to be like Sparty when he grows up. Well, what methods does he have for getting himself up there? Because all these guilds, and, you know, not every guild is like DGs or Zeros to Heroes, well, where they'll look outside your item level. A lot of guilds focus on that item level, and that's fine, right, to an extent. So, gearing up. So my little alt here does need some gear, right? Like, how can I show this guild that I will put in the effort? Well, you know, depending on the type of guild you're looking to join, if you're looking to join a mythic-style guild, well, they clearly want some effort on your part as well. And, you know, applying, we can talk about that later on and how to apply for guilds and which guilds are right for you. but most guilds want to see some semblance of effort coming out. Well, if, you know, lazy-ass Spartana here doesn't upgrade any of his gear because he's too lazy to do a heroic or mythic dungeon, and it's completely, like, it's so easy to do these, right? You can do LFR, you can do whatever you want to get Valor, and just upgrade your stuff. It's a free 10 item levels. It's make your character stronger by doing easy stuff. Why wouldn't you do that? And so if you're looking to apply to a guild, and you haven't done a lot of the, you know, the very basic things like, you know, gemming your gear, or enchanting your stuff with, there, you know, I've got a Heroic Intuition's Gift here that has a, you know, 75 crit gem. If you don't do those kinds of things, these are the basics expected of, you know, most guilds. Whether it's enchants, and obviously the red enchants, no crit strike for paladins, or Thunderlord here. You know, you want to be doing these very basic things at the very least. So, well, how do I get gear? Well, again, getting into heroics first. So start into PvP, right? Get the PvP gear. That's one of the easiest ways to do it. Otherwise, use that Wowhead link, which helps you find all those ways to get geared. And then you start doing your Legendary Ring. Hopefully, you've already started it by then. This guy's almost finished it, which is great. This is a lot of effort from little Spartan over here. Beyond that, it's upgrading your gear. If you do all those things, this guy's 728. If I've upgraded all my stuff right now, he'd likely be 730. And realistically, 730, at a 730 item level, I should be killing a Mythic Zul'Harak. That item level is what it's geared for. So lots of different ways to get geared. Well, Sparty, you know, this guild wants this item level in heroics. So you're 710, for instance, some of you guys are 710 out there, and this guild wants 720. Okay, fair enough. Well, you're 710, you've done heroic, right? You want to kill Heroic Archimonde. What could you do, besides complaining, to help your item level, to help, you know, bolster your case? Number one is those Valor upgrades, right? That is a free 10 item levels across the board. Super easy to get done. Right? Just do Valor, just put in a little bit of effort and time, and you'll be fully geared up. Okay, what else can you do? Well, you can also show them logs, right? You can show them that, you know, I'm a great player. And logs we can touch on later, but you know, a lot of guilds will look at logs and say, hey, yeah, this guy is high ranking this percentile as a healer or DPS or whatever, and pushing good numbers, and guilds will give you that shot as well to help raid with them, you know, those pickup groups as well. But let's say I've got Spartana here, again, which is our fun little, you know, 720 raider. He's got some experience. What has he done so far? Let's take a look here. He's done, you know, some mythics, obviously, with the Zeros to Heroes group. He's done some heroics, because I bring him to heroics and I get him carried. Or I carry other people, rather. But, you know, let's say he is a 5 out of 13 mythic player. Well, when you're looking for guilds, ideally you always want to step up. You want to go to the higher and higher and higher echelon each time. Just because this guy's completed, I don't know, what's that, 10 mythics, doesn't mean that he's ready for a 10 out of 13 mythic guild. And the reason for that is the amount of kills. So he's got, you know, a single kill on most of these bosses. He could have been carried the entire time. I don't know. Right? He could have been dead the entire time, and he's got an achievement now. He's got a kill under his belt. And some guilds will look at that and say, yeah, he's got a kill, ready to bring him in. Other guilds will take a look at the log and say, okay, well, he clearly didn't do anything this fight. He died right away. He must have bought his kill. And that's one way that a lot of people will sort of get that experience, right? They'll get the achievement. Death Jesters, for instance, we've been selling runs, I don't know, for years, since Wrath. Right now we do Hellfire Citadel runs, so people buy the achievements, they buy the gear, and that helps them put their foot in the door for Mythic raiding, right? Somebody pays, you know, whatever the price is, 1 million, 2 million gold for gear, and they get a ton of gear, they get ready to go, they see some of the strats as well, and they're ready to get into that early level mythic rating. So, those are some ways to get geared up. Well, okay, well, where do I get this experience? You have to start talking to people. I know in this whole new day and age of, you know, millennials, and as much as I'm going to shit on you guys for a bit, don't be afraid to talk to people. What's the worst that's going to happen? If you ask some guild, and I have people ask me, right? I have people ask me all the time, hey, you know, my guild's not raiding this week, or, you know, can I help your guild? I'm fully geared up. What's the worst something's, like, what's the worst I'm going to say? No. Like, I'm not going to dig me and say, oh, no, you know, you're shit, you can't be playing. No. Like, I explain to people simply, like, I can't invite you because it's a guild policy unless you're an applicant in the guild, which you're more than welcome to apply, and then we go from there. But we typically don't bring outside people. A lot of other guilds, they will fill them no problem. I know when my raid leader, Branhista, she has a weekend guild, and now they've cleared 13 out of 13 Mythic. But you know what? They were bringing pugs in. They're a bunch of really solid players. They raid once a week, and they brought in pugs every single week because they could not fill spots. And that was a great opportunity for a lot of the Zeros to Heroes guys, Vox, whatever, to sort of show what they can do. You know, they would pug those two spots on Mythic Archimon. I'm not sure how she had the patience for it, but there's plenty of guilds that will give you a chance. Now, if you're decently geared, if you have the achievements, they'll give you a shot. So, plenty of different ways. And that's why you love logs. Yeah, logs are fantastic, like Showa says here. Logs really show how well you're doing. They give you the full picture. And Warcraft logs we're going to talk on later. I'm going to do a whole other Coach's Corner on Warcraft logs again. They've really revamped Warcraft logs since the last time I did a Coach's Corner on it. But it shows you talents, specs, you know, item levels, what gear you're wearing, how much damage you did, what your uptime was. It shows you everything. So logs really are one of the best measures of player skill. So, so you want to get experience. It just comes down to talking to people. In Legion, again, we will be doing plenty of viewer and sub raids. So for those of you looking to get your foot in the door, get some raiding done, you've never raided before, I will friggin' teach you. I will be more than happy to teach you the mechanics, how to communicate, how to tank. You know, for instance, we were doing LFR earlier today, and I mentioned the tanks. You know, listen, when, you know, you have a boss and there's crap under him and your melee friends can't stand, it is time to move the boss, right? That's how we sort of teach things. So that's something, you know, we want to have with you guys. Because really, you guys are the next generation of raiders. I'm not here to demean you guys and, you know, like a lot of other elitist raiders and call you guys crap because you were never, you know, you don't know. Well, guess what? I've been playing this game for 13 years now, right? Is it 13? Too long? And we're always still learning. We all started off as noobs somewhere. Somebody else gave us a bit of a start, right? Maybe it was somebody gave us bags or gave us a tip. And maybe I was leveling as a Holy Paladin or a Warlock and people gave me tips. Like, hey, you should probably, you know, use some weak auras. Or here are some resources for doing some actual damage. So instead of shitting on the next person that you do LFR with, how about you give them a resource, right? Maybe they want to improve, right? They want to become like you, good players, but they have no flipping clue where to go. Like, literally, they have no idea. They could Google, like, how to become better at Warcraft. Leads them to Noxic, right? And we all know where that leads. So help these guys out. You know, give them those resources. You know, they want to improve too. Tell them where to go. You know, between Icy Veins and Wowhead and Mochamp, those are some of the best resources out there right now. And there's plenty of blogs out there. There's plenty of theorycrafting websites for specific classes and specs. So when you're looking for getting experience, talk to people. Talk to other guilds. Zeros to Heroes, and that's another one I'll advertise here. Zeros to Heroes is our community guild. I've got my own guild, Death Jesters. Right, that's a mythic guild. It's one of the longest guilds really in existence. Where January 27th, 2005 is when I created the guild. We're still raiding at a pretty high level. We've done it all. And now what I did last year was I created a community guild, which is Zeros to Heroes. Really those zeros, the LFR zeros to heroic raiders, to mythic raiders, normal raiders, whatever. And it's a great community of flourishing players. Everybody's awesome to each other. There's no elitists or jerks or anything like that. Multiple raid teams, you know, there's one raid team, Team Wobble Gobble, ignore the name, but those guys have gone from normals to heroics to mythics, and now they're fully mythic clearing on a 2-day-a-week schedule. That's pretty awesome. For people that have never done mythic before, they have now fully cleared mythic Archimonde, and now they're just farming mounts, which is great. There's other raid teams, there's a heroic raid team just geared for heroics, for those that never want to step foot into mythic, they just don't care. You know, there's weekend groups, there's teaching raids, there's a lot of that stuff, and it's a great flourishing community. So you have to find guilds, find places that are going to help you out in that sense, that are going to give you those opportunities to learn. Again, Zeros to Heroes is one of them. So getting part of that experience is just getting inside those raids, right? Sometimes it's just you need to go into a pug, you know, go into general chat, trade chat, whatever it is, and find that pug. Do heroic dungeons. Do heroic Archimon stuff. You know, you don't have a guild. You might have to suffer through some of those really menial, terrible pugs and get some logs. And show players, hey, listen, guys, I can, like, I've got amazing numbers here. For my item level, and this is where we can check, right? You know, we don't look at it, somebody that's like 740 and 710, and who did more damage? Well, obviously the 740, right, because of gear. You know, skill aside. We look at the 710, based off their item level, how are they doing? Healing, damage, how are their uptimes, right? What spells are they casting? Do they know their stuff? Well, those are some of the basic requirements of, you know, of raiding. Somebody had a good question here. One sec. Morris had a question. Yeah, and what it comes down to in Legion is just play whatever you enjoy. It doesn't matter. You know, class specs, all that stuff. Play something that resonates really well with you. I'm a Holy Paladin in real life. I've been playing a Holy Paladin since 2000 when I was playing EverQuest. I've stuck with a Paladin ever since because I love that class and I love the playstyle and the fantasy and that battle healer. I'm just going back into Legion now. So, so here, I got some great questions from like Leslie. You know, Leslie's a recruitment officer in his guild. Warlords to kind of force you to take a few steps back just to maintain a viable group. That's what you have to do sometimes, right? Like, if you're a 10 out of 13 raider, heroic, mythic, whatever, in order to find that sweet spot of a guild, you may have to take a step back to a 9 out of 13, but then you will enjoy raiding that much more, right? Because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter if you're a heroic, mythic, raider, whatever, what matters is the experiences and the memories you've made, right? How much do you enjoy playing this game? It's not a job unless, you know, you're making money off of it, so you need to find a way to have fun. What are the hardest specs to fill? It varies, right? We were looking for a tank for a year. Like, we were going through tank applicant after tank applicant after tank applicant. It took a long time, and now we have three tanks. We had four tanks at one point, back in Mogushan Vaults, tier 14, and now we're down to three tanks. We've had those three tanks since tier 14, so we're not really looking for tanks. Same thing, it depends. Healers, DPS, it depends what you're looking for. But really the hardest part, and you know, recruiting or raiding and everything aside, not standing in fire, you know, good DPS, the hardest part of raiding or raid leading is recruiting good people for your team. Trust me, I've been doing it for 13 years. That is by far the most difficult thing to do. You know, finding good players that will stick around, that are loyal, that will put in the effort, that, you know, are not drama queens, are you know, not going to bail on you, that are good enough players that can do the same schedule you want. It's really tough to find those players, are the right class you want and spec and everything else. It's very tough to find those kind of players. So, it's tough. But yeah, so going back to gearing here, lots of ways to get geared up using that Wowhead link. Gearing up for 6.2.3. Mythic dungeons are available, right? Up to 735 item level. So we can get mythic quality loot from dungeons. Hellfire Citadel loot, again, starting normals, heroics, and then eventually mythics. But it just comes down to talking to people, starting to, you know, apply to guilds. And I will take a look at a couple of guilds here really quick, where let's say we look at a guild on Stormrage. So here we go. So let's take a look at some guilds in Stormrage. So this website is WoW Progress. We'll take a look at this for a little bit. These are the guilds. There's the Heroes, 21st on the server. It is a big server. You know, let's say you're, again, you know, you want to get into Mythic raiding. Well, just because you've completed, you know, all the heroics doesn't mean you should jump right into a 5 out of 13 Mythic guild. Maybe you're ready for it. You know, who knows? But for the most part, you should be jumping into an early or entry-level Mythic guild, which is probably one of these guys, right? This one's a 2 out of 13. Maybe you want to jump into a 3 out of 4 out of 13. This one's called Piety. Let's click on these guys. Get a pretty decent name. So they've done, let's see what they've done here. They've done Cromrock, Hellfire, Kilrog, and Serpathar, which is an interesting setup. Not a lot of information about these guys, so maybe you don't want to choose these guys. Let's choose another guild here really quick. Let's choose GK. Let's see if they've done the right bosses. Yeah, so they've done these bosses in order as you're supposed to. They're a former 120 whatever guild from Hordes out of Zul'jin. They take progression very seriously. We can offer you a short 9-hour raid week with serious progression, and we always are on the lookout for skilled players. So they raid Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, 8:30 to 11:30. You know, those are the raid times. And then you would start, you know, going to their website, which is peak GK guild here on Engine, and go from there. So if you're that heroic kind of player, these are the kinds of guilds that you probably should be jumping to once you're ready to leave your current guild. And, you know, when do you leave your current guild? Well, when things aren't working out anymore. But yeah, Wild Progress is one of the best resources for finding guilds out there. It lists all the guilds based off their progression ranking, you know, based off 3 days, 4 days, whatever. Here, Alliance. Let's say, I don't know, I'm an Alliance person because Alliance Master Race. Actually, you know what? Let's go US here. So here are all the US guilds. You can see Horde, Alliance, whatever. And I like to show this pretty often for you guys. So these are all the guilds on US, right? Including Oceanic. I am an Alliance guy. I want to find a guild. What am I thinking here? I want to find a guild that raids 3 days a week. That is, you know, pretty semi-hardcore. 3 days a week, you know, doesn't say what days. I want a guild that speaks English. And what am I? I am a paladin. What kind of paladin? Well, the best kind of paladins. I'm a holy paladin. Show me what guilds that are Alliance US speaking English looking for a holy paladin that raid 3 days a week. There you go. These are all the guilds that are specifically looking for a holy paladin, meeting this criteria. I don't want to go to those dirty rock-eating horde. I want to stay Alliance no matter what. 3 days a week, English, looking for paladin that is holy. Well, again, now I'm going to go through all these guilds here and find one that is probably appropriate to my skill level. Right? It doesn't hurt to shoot higher. Right? Totally fine. Let's go Endless Kingdoms on Proudmoore. They're a 6 out of 13 guild. Looks pretty decent. Let's see. It looks like they've skipped Gorefiend. Yeah, they did Shadowlord Iskar the other day. They're recruiting all classes. Maybe not specifically a Holy Paladin. Endless Kingdom is part of the Eternal Kingdom of Alliance Guilds. Never heard of them. Let's see. Our Mythic Progression Raid Team. So they have a lot of progression teams. Quite a few. Some are 13 out of 13 Mythic. Some are 5 out of 13. Very interesting. So they've got quite a few here. So that you'd look at, you know, their websites, see these guilds, and, you know, maybe get some gear. And this is one of those contentious points. Well, what if I really don't like this guild, but I'm going to use them for gear? Okay, so the one aspect of it is, yeah, I mean, it sounds like a pretty scumbag thing to do, to use a guild to get gear and then go to apply to a different guild. In reality, that's sort of what happens in real life as well, right? You start off with a small job and get the experience and you get the money and eventually you move on to something greater. The same thing with a lot of guilds, and again, it's nothing against you guys or the guilds, that's sort of what happens. What you can do is you can be honest and upfront, like, hey, you know, I do eventually want to, you know, join a 13 out of 13 mythic guild, but don't be a scumbag in the sense of, like, get geared up and leave, right? There's good ways to leave guilds, right? Let people know, give them the heads up, you know, let them know that you're looking for a higher progressed guild or things aren't working out, and give them some time to find a replacement for you. But yeah, like, I wouldn't, let's say if I'm a heroic raider, I would not jump to a 5 out of 13 guild, get geared up in a week, like, get decked out, and then leave the next week. That is a big scumbag thing to do. But if you join that 5 out of 13 guild, and they gear you up, progress with them a little bit, you know, work on the 6th, 7th boss maybe, and once you feel, you know, you're ready to make that next jump to the next level of guilds, apply to that 9 or 10 out of 13 mythic guild. Right? That's sort of the decent thing to do, right? We want to promote you guys being decent human beings. So yes, that's some of the best ways to get experience. Work your way up slowly, right? You don't jump from, you know, 1 out of 13 mythic to 13 out of 13 mythic. Obviously, there's exceptions. And in the same sense, just because you're 13 out of 13 mythic now does not mean that, you know, you're ready to make the jump to, you know, like a top US 50 guild. No offense. Just because you've killed it now, it's a whole different ballgame. People are not, you know, they don't realize how big of a jump it is going from a guild like, you know, like Zeros to Heroes, which is our community guild. I don't think Zeros to Heroes is recruiting on this one. Zeros to Heroes, our community guild, to a guild like Death Jesters. There's a lot more involved, and a lot more research and prep work and just theorycrafting and knowledge and skill and all that other kind of stuff, despite both skills being 13 out of 13 right now, right? There's not a lot of players in Zeroes to Heroes that could make that jump, despite all being 13 out of 13. So, on Warcraft, what do the tiers mean? These are all different tiers. So, last tier, tier 17, right? Tier 17, you guys remember, which was Blackrock Foundry? Well, Midwinter was number one U.S. guild, right? Those are the different tiers, the raid tiers. Tier 15, so the last expansion, right? 25 men and 10 men, back when we did Siege of Orgrimmar, right? Fun times. Oh, sorry, this was, tier 16 was Siege of Orgrimmar. Tier 15 was Rodan and Lichen and everything. So now it's all 20-man mythic, right? That's what the raid tier means. What's the best way to practice raiding? It's a great question. What is the best way to practice raiding? Well, you know what? I have a number of mythic raiders. A lot of these guys here are mythic raiders. Natora, my best elemental shaman. Midgets here, Conrad, Happy, all these guys. Those are mythic raiders. We went to LFR today to practice some of the bosses. Yeah, LFR is a really watered-down version, and we can do the LFR argument a different time, but it was practice of mechanics. Yeah, some of the mechanics are exactly the same from Mythic to LFR. You know, the more experience you have, despite what it is, the better. If it's going to take you 30 hours to kill a boss, or however many hours, you know, 10 hours to kill a boss, realistically, well, you can get some of those hours done early on, by putting in that time to see the mechanics, see what the raid looks like, get used to the timings, you know, when to use your cooldowns. Some of the best practice in learning to raid is just doing it. I mean, you could watch all the videos, and this is what I get from a lot of applicants. You know their stuff. They're great theory crafters. You know, they know their rotations, they know their spell power coefficients, they know their crit ratings for different specs, whatever. They know the boss encounters too. They know them inside and out. But putting it into practice, that's what's sort of missing, right? When I would put these guys, these that are great, you know, theory crafters, and you know, they threw through their interview so well into an actual raid, they didn't do so well because they were really slow to learn in that sense. So, yeah, LFR is a great way to practice. LFR is great because it's right now. Like, right now on beta, I have LFR available. I would totally do another one to give people more practice. Right? Normal's available as well. Last week, on Wednesday, we did multiple LFR raids, or multiple normal raids for my Mythic Raiders to give them practice of the mechanics, right? Some of the stuff, you know, goes up from, where is it, raids? Yeah, so we did Nthendra, Ranfarl here, and Illagoth. We did these three bosses multiple times. Because we were able to practice some of the Mythic positioning, we've tested these bosses on Mythic, we're able to practice some of the mythic positioning, the heroic positioning, some of the changes on normal. Right? Because the movement, the dance pattern doesn't really change. It's more and more practice, like anything else. Learning to play guitar, playing a sport, ping pong, whatever. The more you do it, the better you get at it. As long as you're constantly striving to improve, right? I have you guys on stream here to critique me all the time, you know, and call me out on stuff. That's great. Great for my own personal improvement, right? Feel free to criticize any time. And yeah, you know, these kinds of encounters, you know, we're able to really test mechanics, make sure people know them, get a good handle of them, until, when Legion comes out, well, now I'm not wiping, you know, 10 times because somebody didn't, you know, have enough experience with it. Everybody in my guild's got beta keys, right? We're all expected to practice these bosses, to know them, especially on the early ones. On Mythic, I mean, I know Mythic is really terrible timings in terms of testing, but you know, any kind of practice is good practice. Yeah, and there's nothing wrong with... Yeah, that's a big thing. You know, you're looking to, you know, to jump to a higher guild through gearing and experience and everything else. I think the servers are crashing, actually. There's nothing wrong with asking questions. Do not be afraid of asking questions. If somebody, you know, talks shit to you because you asked them a question of like, hey, do you know any good Holy Paladin resources? They are not worth your time. Don't bother with those kinds of people. Like, I talk to paladins that are better than me, I talk to raid leaders that are better than me, guild leaders that are pretty good, and I bounce ideas off them, I get some theory off them, you know, I use Del's weak auras right now, but I asked Del the other day, hey, you got some weak auras for Legion? He's like, yeah, just the ones I made myself. I'm like, perfect, now I don't have to do this. Thank you, Del. Or I've got these ones, which are all Emerald Nightmare weak auras. Every single one of these ones. Look at these. Look at these. Look at these amazing Weakauras, all ready to go for Emerald Nightmare. Thank you, Rollo. Right, these guys, use them as a resource. Use your friends as a resource to help you out. Because why not? Why wouldn't you? Where's a good place to learn boss fights? And again, getting that experience. Well, at the very basic level, LFR. We queue as a guild for LFR when we're doing Valor stuff or we're trying to get some experience like today. Beyond that, normals are great. When I'm changing keybinds around or I'm practicing new talents, I'll do five-man dungeons. I won't jump right into a mythic raid, a progression raid, with a brand new talent setup and a brand new keybind setup. No, you gotta get used to those things. Right? It's all muscle memory. That's my point here. The more you do these things, the better your muscle memory gets. So yeah, learning these boss fights in-game, best way. That is the best way. Beyond that, there's plenty of guide videos out there. I know Fat Boss, and honestly, I don't know. You know, these days, I just YouTube. I'll go to YouTube. I will, I don't know. Let's pick a fight here. Ursoc. So I will go Mythic Ursoc. Here we go. Here are all the Mythic Ursoc fights. Now, you'd have to remember that some of these guys are, best of 59%, Alpha Legion, so it might have been a while ago. And the fights do change from Alpha to Beta builds or different Mythic encounters. So, again, take a look at when it was done. I would watch the videos, you know, take a look at their positioning, why they're doing certain things. It's not enough to just, you know, okay, they're standing over here. But why are they standing there? Why are they spread out? Why do they only have a clump of X amount of players for Mythic? There's a reason, right? And you should know those things as Mythic players. Those Emerald Gems, they're here. Here we go. You guys want the Emerald Gem Weakauras? They're right there. The best part is when they learn enough to beat you. That's great. I mean, I'd love to see that. In DJs, we're often mentoring, you know, other players, other applicants. When I mentor the other Holy Paladin, Photon, I would be on his ass, like, why did you only get 9 casts of, you know, Flash of Light on this encounter, and I got 14? Well, no, don't give me excuses about haste. Mash the crap out of your buttons, right? ABCs, always be casting. And now he became a better paladin than I am. And now he's old and retired. So, again, a lot of it is just practice, doing your research, you know, the very basic stuff is, you know, doing dungeon journals, okay. So you know that, you know, Ursoc has a charge on normal. Okay. Well, how many players are going to split? Depending on the raid size, right? So you know he has his... Where is it? He has Trampling Slam. So it's going to do 1,000,000 damage to the player. That might kill somebody, right? I mean, for the most people, it's going to do a ton of damage. The Barreling Impact is... this one. Yeah, right here. You know, it's going to charge right through momentum. Yeah, do lots of damage to people all in the way. And these players suffer increased damage from momentum for 50%. Well, that's where you're going to need alternate groups for momentum, right? However many people for dealing with Ursoc. So, it's very basic stuff to look at dungeon journals. I would expect heroic raiders to look at dungeon journals and sort of see. Mythic raiders, I expect them to go through videos, multiple videos, different perspectives. If I can find a Holy Paladin perspective of a video... of a guy doing, you know, mythic Ursoc or Cenarius, then yeah, that's the one I'm going to use. I won't necessarily use a tank perspective. I may look at that one, but I'll be looking through the other ones more importantly. As a main healer, what always makes me improve is looking at other guilds' logs at the same class and see how many X they are getting in and Y time and compared to my own. Exactly, and that's how I, when we looked at Ash's logs, right? Ash is one of our Zeros to Heroes paladins. And when we were looking at logs together, I would show him, hey, you have this many heals, I have this many heals. You need to spam the crap out of this button. Despite it not being the selfless healer rotation, you need more and more HPS. None of this downtime between spells. You are always casting something. And that's, again, that's what it comes down to with a lot of players. You know, why am I doing so little DPS? It's because you're okay, clicking aside, you know, you're hitting a button, you hit another button, you hit another button. No. You mash the crap out of your buttons. You want to maximize as many spells in that 1 minute period. Well, how is that going to happen? By hitting the crap out of your buttons. You know, RUWSAD keys, ASD keys rubbed out? Well, good, from overuse, right? Or your E's or 3's or however you got your keys bound. And we covered key bindings and macros and weak auras in our previous Coach's Corner. Right, here's another really good one. And yeah, right now the, what's it called? I've got the weak auras here for Emerald Nightmare, right? Well, what if you want to track a certain one, right? Here are the Emerald Nightmare weak auras. What if I want to track something specifically? Well, where I would go is Wowhead. Let's take a look at, I don't know, give me a boss fight here. Let's use Ursoc as an example. Okay, so we got Ursoc right here. And Ursoc is, where are you, bastard? 75, close of Ursoc, quest, NPCs. The right Ursoc or the wrong one? I can't see without my glasses. Region dungeon changes. Yeah, Ursoc, spell that right. Where's under bosses? Guides, talents. Claws of Ursoc, 750. Oh, those are the artifact ones. Very cool. Oh, wrong Wowhead. You're right. Thank you. Wrong Wowhead. I should be using the Legion Wowhead. Good call. Thank you. Thank you guys for correcting me. See, you know, even I miss stuff. Legion Wowhead. There we go. Perfect. That makes sense. Thank you. All right. Where are you? Used ancient. Is he here? Nope, wrong one. One second, let me pull it up here. Pulling up. Where's that bastard? Guides, icons. Okay. Well, the point I wanted to make was find a debuff. Okay, this was my point here. If I want to find the debuff, damage from momentum, let's take a look at Wowhead. Momentum. Here we go. Let me actually show you guys what I meant. So this is the one I was actually looking for, why I was looking for Ursoc. So here is momentum, the debuff where he charges through X amount of people. Well, what do I do? Well, that's great. Right, I've got the debuff here. How do I turn it into a weak aura? Well, here's great. Something great. I can copy and paste. And so what it's going to look like. So when I load this into weak auras, and I'm going to new import. Thank you. And so now I've got something tracking the momentum debuff. Right? That is how long I have the momentum debuff. So that's making a weak aura for that specific boss character. That's what I expect from Mythic Raiders, right? Or really steal Mythic auras from everywhere else. So anyway, lots of different ways to prep and get geared up, but it just comes down to getting in there, right? Get yourself prepped, do the very basic prep of watching a couple of videos, getting experience that way. Start doing pugs or talking to other guild and see if you can fill a spot for them, right? You can quickly look at WoW progress. Again, WoW progress on whatever server you are. So here's WoW progress again. I don't know, let's pick a different server. Let's choose another US server. Let's choose Kel'Thuzad. There. These are the guilds on Kel'Thuzad that have, you know, completed, or whatever the progression is, right? They're a mostly alliance-based server. So let's say I am 9 out of 13 or 10 out of 13. Let's say nobility here stops raiding. They're like, okay, well, now we've stopped raiding, what can we do? Well, I still want to raid with these guys, or maybe I don't. I'm going to start looking at guilds that are 12 out of 13, maybe 11 out of 13, and see if these guys need a Holy Paladin. Right? Well, they're recruiting all classes, they raid 3 days per week here. This is pretty decent write-up. Except they raid really late. 10 p.m. until 1 p.m. AST. That is way too late for me. So, start talking to these guys. Start whispering them, in case they do need that extra player. So this is to the stream here. What other ways have you guys found to get experience? You know, besides, you know, the ways I've mentioned, what other ways have you guys gotten your foot in the door? Whether it be with a guild or getting gear or whatever. yeah, we can use your garrison stuff and give you your mythic cash or your hero cash every week. But what ways do you get more experience? What are some of the best tools you guys use for finding out, you know, how to get gear, how to get experience? Researching boss fights on a different level, right? Well, if you bought this, there's always a bot at this. Yes, there's always a bot in YouTube. So you ran Pugs during Ice Crown. That's a great way to get experience. Absolutely, Antivirus. Just on the way, any way you can. Like, if you want to raid, you will find a way to raid. Don't make excuses. Every one of you damn monkeys are capable of raiding Mythic. I don't care if it's one day a week. Oh, I don't have time to do Mythic raiding. Bullshit. Okay, there are guilds out there that clear Mythic on one day. Yeah, the 10 out of 10 Valor, that Valor has helped, but there are plenty of guilds out there that can do it on a one-day schedule. So can you. Okay, take that as motivation enough. Every one of you guys can do it. Again, a lot of you guys, a lot of these current Mythic Raiders, were LFR heroes, right? Those little LFR guys, normal, casual, heroic, they never saw what the hoopla of Mythic Raiding was, right? Until they started watching these streams and see how excited some of us get for Mythic Raiding. It's fun. It's crazy fun to play with your friends like this. Jirazi says here, on this repetition, I ran lower tier items till I was max experience. People invited me places. That's exactly right. So that goes back to doing heroics first, right? You want to get into Mythic Raiding? Well, don't apply to a guild when you're full of normals, right? Normal items. Get as much as you can for your current level. Then go. Then shoot for the sky. Shoot for the stars. Yeah, a lot of repetition is great. You paid in heroic carries and submit those logs to the top guilds? That's totally viable, for sure. Watching streams is a good one. Most UV streamers will answer any questions you have. And that's a great thing about Twitch, right? You can find some streamers that will answer your questions. And we're trying to propagate a really awesome community here. I would start your own dungeon guild and get practice and skills. So Romps has got a good one here. So I wouldn't recommend starting your own guild, but I would recommend starting your own groups. You know, that group doesn't want to take you for Mythics. They don't want to take you for the raid because your item level's too low. And guess what? Start your own damn raid. Just because that heroic Archmon group wants 720 and you're only 710 or 715, heaven forbid you're 719 and they won't take you, start your own damn group. Nothing wrong with that. You don't have to raid lead it. Right? You've obviously, you know, hopefully done the encounter on normal. There's only very minor changes from normal to heroic anyway. You don't need to be a, you know, amazing raid leader for heroic Archmon anyway, or a lot of the other bosses. Yeah, a lot of these guys, like Islet here, started raiding the world as Raynor. Now they're 13 out of 13 Mythic Raiders. Let's see, a segue. I started playing World's Raynor. I just did Pugs to get experience. Then I joined Zeros to Heroes, cleared 13 out of 13 Heroic with them, and was able to Pug 2 Mythic Bosses. Exactly! I've got a lot of really cool Twitch messages from players, and these guys are like, yeah, you know, Sparty, Syntax was one of our most recent ones. He did, you know, all Heroics, and eventually he was able to apply to a Mythic guild, because that's where his, you know, his dreams were. He wants to go to those guilds. Great! Go for it! You know, if you want to use Zeros to Heroes as a stepping stone, okay, let us know, right? Obviously, we're not going to, you know, throw gear at you and let you go, but we want you to work your way up there. Primal here says, I joined a Middleworld's Arena, a reroll guild, and we struggled to down normal Archimond. They disbanded, I got my item level up alone, joined a new guild. Okay, so he got his item level up alone. Primal, how did you get your item level up alone? What did you do? PvP? Ring stuff? Right, ring pugs to get your legendary ring up, valor upgrades. So he joined a new guild after being out of one for so long, and now he's 7 out of 13 mythic and 731 end level. Exactly! You can always find a way to raid. There's always opportunities and avenues out there. Right? He lost a guild. Guess what? He made the best of it. He did what he could without a guild. That's awesome. If you think you're not good enough or there's a lot of competition, find a guild. Life is always better with a guild. Exactly! Life is always better when you're playing with friends. This is an MMO game. It's not, you know, a solo RPG like Witcher. Witcher is fantastic, by the way. You're meant really to play with friends and have that social interaction. That's great. So I joined a guild made by a few people who pushed me to heroic 25 man back in Wrath, and we're wanting to do Mythics. They seem friendly enough, but I need to see how I fit in during the weeks up to Legion. Exactly. Now is the best time. People always ask, you know, when is the best time to find a guild? When should I get experience? Should I just, you know, resub in Legion? No! I keep telling you guys, the best time to find a guild is right now. Because if you can find that guild right now and find that core spot and you love a guild, great. Or you could wait till Legion, and guess what? They filled that spot. That Holy Paladin spot you wanted to fill? Yeah, no, sorry. Sucks to be you. You waited too long. Alternatively, you join this guild in World of Draenor during this content lull, and you find out this guild's full of asshats, and you just don't want to raid with them. That's great, because now you'll have more time to find another guild. Better to find out it doesn't work out now than in Legion. If you join a guild in Legion, and you find out it's people that you really hate, and you know one guy has a really nasally voice, and one girl just keeps talking and won't shut up on Mumble, well, now you're going to leave this guild in Legion, and you're without a guild, while everybody else is progressing. Right? You're sort of shooting yourself in the foot here by not finding a guild or a team now. Yeah, I love Witcher Realm, so I'm a big fan of the Witcher series. Joined a guild as it formed 2 months ago. Last night we down 230 Mythic. Couldn't be happy. That's fantastic, Vince! Vince, that's awesome, dude! That is fantastic. Great news. Sparty, as you've just seen, I'm a 740 whatever raider. I go join LFRs and help newcomers with their rotations. I also openly help out 1130 guilds and alt in order to educate. Exactly! Like, I do the same thing with our Zeros to Heroes, and that's exactly the right kind of attitude you want to have in this community. I believe in that's fantastic. So this guy's 740 plus priest, killed Mythic Archimonde a bunch of times. He joins LFRs out of the goodness of his heart, and I guess he has a lot of patience, and helps these guys along. Like, hey, you know, he sees another Shadow Priest. Like, hey, try doing this rotation. I, you know, I'm a pretty good player. Let me give you, like, you want some tips? That is fantastic. Great. Yeah, that's awesome. That's exactly what we want. Because you want to keep propagating this good community. You don't want to have this community full of really terrible, you know, elitist bastards, right? That are super antisocial and they don't like talking to people. And we're trying to make a good community. That's the big thing here. Those new guys, so the Shadow Priest that Oblivion's going to help out is the next generation of Raider. You never know that that guy that you guys just helped out, they may apply to your guild 2 years down the line. And they will remember that experience. Hey, you helped me out. Right? I remember this guy, right? He helped me out. He gave me bags when I was a little paladin in Northshire Abbey. This guy gave me bags. That was a huge deal. Those are the memories you make. Currently the raid leader for a guild on Illidan. A lot of us are coming back to, from BC. Good. The majority of our core group can pull their own weight. DPS not dying. That's good. My main concern are raiders that are newish are struggling with the mechanics of fights. We did 13th normal in Hellfire Citadel for our first guild run ever. Is that a decent amount of progress? I mean, it all varies, but yes, it is a good amount of progress. And the best ways to get more progress, more experience, right? It's totally fine for a fresh guild run. I mean, I don't know what the item levels are of your players, but again, LFRs, dungeons, normals, heroics, mythics, and then just doing more and more dungeons. It'll get easier. I remember, okay, this is a really good throwback to Siege of Orgrimmar, because I know how much we loved it. When I used to do flex raids to teach, and I miss flex raids so much, because I could just join a wing on normal, and it'd be great, or flex difficulty, and I would teach you guys mechanics. The same mechanics in normal and heroic. I miss that. Anyway, when we did flex for the first time, I had a lot of players that were just LFR players, right? A lot of missing mechanics from LFR, and it was flex difficulty, so slightly under, you know, normal. And we were wiping. People were dying left, right, and center. Part of the reason was inexperience. Yeah, it did slightly more damage. They were all, you know, decently geared for flex, trust me. But they had no idea about these new mechanics. I remember a lot of those guys like Whammos and a lot of you guys here doing those flex raids for the first time. We were wiping all over the place. With a few months of experience, we were just steamrolling it. Yeah, we had more gear, but we were steamrolling it. People knew the mechanics. They communicated well. It was fantastic. So it takes a little bit of time. I had a hard time looking for a guild that was looking to help a new player. Those guilds are out there, Reckless. I guarantee those guilds are out there. My problem is I've been playing for 2 years and I can't find the life of me to choose a main. That seems to stick. You gotta keep trying new ones. The great thing in Legion is they have these class trials. So you can find out how a class plays. Let me load it up here really quickly. You find out how a class plays. I loaded up my Death Knight here, Arianna. And I found out how Unholy Death Knights played, right? Throwing up diseases and dots and those kinds of stuff. And then you can decide whether you want to use your level 100 boost or not on that character. And like right now, well, I bring a lot of the Zeros to Heroes guys along, whether they're heroic or mythic or normal raiders, and they get a chance to see these, you know, see these bosses. And yeah, this is my little Death Knight, right? My level 100 Death Knight that I was using the class trials on. So
those are only 403 specs at the moment, Minion. There'll be plenty more. There'll be plenty more out there. End up marrying a person who had helped him become a better mage in Cataclysm.
That's good. All right, so that's it for the most part for gearing up. So what it comes down to, again, guys, is what can you do yourselves? If you're a player, if you have no guild right now, what can you do to better yourselves as a player? Well, part of it's just gearing up, right? What can you do to get geared up? That PvP stuff, Valor gear, starting your legendary quest, working on your legendary quest, doing the research on those boss fights. You know, yeah, it may seem really stupid watching a video of guys, you know, kill a boss fight. Like, no, I can figure this out on my own. But guess what? By spending those 3 minutes, you're potentially saving your guild lots and lots of, you know, yelling in the future when you mess up on a mechanic because you didn't know, because you didn't bother doing the research. So, doing the research is there, and then you just gotta find a way to raid. Finding pugs, talk to friends. Again, I'm always available here. You can always add my battle tag, Sparty1780, or tweet me or Facebook me, and I'll always answer your questions. Whether I'm streaming or not, I totally. Like, it's better to bug me when I'm not streaming, and I'll answer your questions. And sometimes here, like, if you need help with a dungeon, sure, I'll do a dungeon with you. Why not? Or I'll say I'm really busy. I personally had the best experience when I started. This is from Fox Junior Gaming. I went to Star Wars Drainer, which wasn't that long ago. I was leveling and decided to go to Stormwind just for fun. I entered and waved at some level 100 dude. He asked me if I was new, and I said yes. He then proceeded to help me with gold for heirlooms. It was the best of my life. We keep in touch now, and he helps me when I have questions. That is fantastic. That is awesome. I would, like, give props to that kind of, like, whoever that is. That is the kind of players we want in-game. And as Mythic Raiders, as Heroic Raiders, as veterans of the game, that is, again, what we want to propagate. That kind of community, that kind of positivity in the game. That's great. And yeah, that's one of the best memories you're going to have in Warcraft. We have plenty more. I've been in the guild since BC, and I'm good friends with a few people, but there's zero push from my guild leader, ready to push me the content. We're 13 out of 13 at least, but it's a struggle. Well, that's a great thing right now, Donchok. You can always do Mythic group or Mythic raids cross-realm. Zeros to Heroes, we started doing, between my guild Death Jesters and Zeros to Heroes, combined teaching Mythic raids. So we'd combine both guilds, whoever's around, on our alts, or their mains, for instance, and we would start teaching them. So people that had never done Mythics before, were part of the Heroic team, got 5 out of 13 Mythic, which was a huge deal. They would have never gotten Mythic kills without it. So it was awesome, and they got their Mythic caches afterwards. They were getting able to get more gear. I'm in England, it's 118, but it's making... Listen, Warcraft is awesome. Yes, the game is old, and you know what? I don't play this game for the amazing new PvE encounters. You know, what new dragon boss, or new old god, or whatever. Some of the encounters are cool. Legion's going to be amazing. The dungeons are fantastic. They're a lot of fun. All that stuff aside, if another Worlds of Draenor came out right now, right? Not, you know, the Blizzard's best effort, but if another one of those expansions came out right now, I would not be playing it for the content, or for the class changes, or for the pet battles, I'd be playing it to play with my friends and have fun. That's why. And that's what it's going to come down to a lot of you guys. What is the most fun for you? What resonates with you as a class? You know, I could spend 50 hours wiping with a guild and have those top 5, you know, world ranks. Or I can spend 12 hours enjoying my, you know, time, or 9 hours, whatever we're going to raid in Legion, and play with people I enjoy with raiding with. That's it. So anyway, that's what you guys need to take home from this one. We'll wind down Coach's Corner, but I will still be around to answer more questions. Anyway, put in the effort, get the work done, and next week we're going to look at how to find a guild. We're going to look at WoW Progress, recruitment forums, trade chat, everything. All the resources for you guys. So in the meantime, while you guys are getting yourselves geared up, getting the experience, next week we're going to look for how to find that perfect guild for you. What resources, what tools are out there, and we'll see you guys next week.